direct this to you, Professor. Thank you for both of you coming in. I'd like you, if you could, to expand a bit more on your theory. You're talking about secularization, the aspect of the market, and if you take Catholics out of the statistical analysis, then it works. But if you put Catholics back in, it doesn't work. I was wondering why that is the case. Why is it particularly Catholics that sort of mess up this economic model that's being proposed?
Well, right. I mean, the problem is double. First of all, Catholic countries do not have typically free markets in religion. And yet they tend to be, this is the second point, tend to be more observant than Protestants do, at least if you look at contemporary survey data. And this turns out to be true on a smaller scale within the United States as well. In the US, you also have the additional problem of Utah. In other words, the Mormons, who don't fit this model terribly well either. And I think actually this anomaly is relatively easy to account for in terms of the kind of organizational political model that I laid out, which is number one, Catholics are the pioneers in the development of missionary strategies, particularly through the use of various kinds of preaching and teaching orders. This is one of the things which Protestantism does away with and doesn't really understand what it's lost. They have a much longer standing tradition of various kinds of parachurch organizations, lay confraternities, sodalities, other kinds of quasi-religious organizations like guilds, which then serve as a kind of a platform or a template during the 19th century for the development of yet other forms of lay association and parachurch organizations. The one thing which, of course, then becomes a problem for Catholics tends to be this close relationship between church and state. And so this is to the degree to which you observe secularization within Catholic countries, it typically arises out of this kind of political conflict between kind of lay Republicans and then increasingly kind of confessionalized democratic mass parties. France is the best European example of this, but Turkey in a way is kind of Fonsipea. I mean, it's even more radical version of that same kind of process of secular radical republicanism.